already episode three. Episode two, we discussed defensive versus offensive footwork and stance. So quick recap, defensive stance is a little shorter. This way we can use our blocks, and we went through three different blocks very quickly. Offensive stance, you're stepping over the line and coming back, okay? Defensive stance, shorter, weight more 50-50. My offensive stance is a little longer. I'm keeping my stance a little longer because in kickboxing you want to kick. So I want a longer stance in my offensive stance because it really helps sets up, wind up my kick. So you can see as if I throw a combination, the long stance allows me to kick with a little bit more power, and I'm back into my defensive stance. Episode three is going to be about the neutral stance. And we're gonna build that into a triangle step, which is very important footwork. So we're gonna be in our regular stance. And remember, we have our right foot back here with Ala, so she's gonna be an orthodox fighter. Matt has his left foot behind, southpaw fighter. Troy has his right foot orthodox. And so all three of them are in a defensive stance, which means a little shorter stance. So from here, we're gonna work an offensive stance with a 1-2. So we step 1-2, but now we're stepping back to our feet side by side, and that's called neutral stance. So if you look at the side view, my feet are perfectly side by side. That is my neutral stance. That's a different stance. So you have your defensive, offensive, I'm in neutral stance. So from neutral stance, we're gonna build in something called the triangle step. So I throw my 1-2 back over the line, my feet are in neutral stance. From here, I have the option of going left or right. So I can shuffle this way, step in, and now I have a new angle. I step in and I have a new angle. So I'm constantly switching. And this is very basic, and I only teach usually two or three shuffles. I want to get it in as like a dance step, a routine. So it's very simple for people to remember. So orthodox stance, step out into neutral stance, shuffle, shuffle, come back in, attack back into the neutral stance. And that's my basic footwork for the triangle step. Now I'm gonna discuss different ways you can drill this. Right now we're just doing it across a line, we're doing it very linear. We're gonna show you how to do it as a circle technique around a stationary object. Let's go through some drilling. One of the most basic and easiest drills you can use to work your triangle step is have a stationary object on the floor. From there, you're able to go into your offensive stance, to your neutral stance, and constantly change angles. So the way Troy is doing this, he's stepping, coming back into neutral, shuffling to a new position, attacking, and coming back into that neutral stance. I want Troy now, he's gonna go constantly around the stationary target. The key to this is constantly be unpredictable with your movement. If you go one way, make sure you go the other way, and constantly confuse your opponent. Twice one way, once the other way. Three one way, one and one. Constantly change how and which side you are attacking with. So here's Troy just constantly mixing it up. The more advanced you get with this footwork, Troy's gonna mix in left and right before he even steps. So he does a little bit of fake. So he gets his opponents guessing which direction he's going. And you can see it's a very good strategy and style if you're fighting a pressure fighter. So you got to picture a pressure fighter coming forward to Troy. Troy exits out, circles, takes a new angle. So triangle stepping is very good when you fight someone who is a good pressure fighter or someone that you want to create angles with. Instead of using a stationary object on the floor, you can use a partner. Matt and I are both using boxing gloves. Coaches can use tie pads, boxing mitts, whatever they really want. Our third drill is gonna be a bag, which we'll show you momentarily. But I like to use just their gloves. It's a little bit more interactive, and it allows partners to give and take. So Matt would usually do a couple minutes of this drill, switch, and then I'll do it. So I don't have to constantly switch pads, take it off. Still very good way to work the drill. So Matt's gonna do it first, we'll switch, I'll do the drill for a few minutes just to show you how the drill works. Matt's a southpaw, he's gonna get in his position, I'm the stationary object just using my hands. Go. Turn, right around, go. So Matt's an MMA fighter, kickboxing background, but with going into mixed martial arts. And this is a very important step for MMA fighters because it keeps them long, and especially Matt doesn't want to be taken down. So if I come in here, he's gone. Matt moves. So I start adding in some pressure fighting in order for him to get the concept of being able to move out of direction, out of range to make himself safe. Okay, and then we can call switch. Matt becomes the stationary object, and then I'll do the triangle stepping. And then again, you can constantly change up combinations the way you want to do it. So I'll just do a 1-1-2 on my enter. There's episode 3, neutral stance and triangle stepping, very important keys when talking about footwork and movement. It's a built-in defense, so you could attack and not be hit and be able to move, create angles. Down the road, as the episodes progress, you're gonna realize how important this footwork and this triangle step and neutral stance is, especially when we talk about switching stances, going from orthodox to southpaw. So keep in mind the footwork in this triangle step, we're gonna revisit it, and it's just gonna get better. So again, subscribe below, like, comment. The more you guys like and comment, I'll create a question and answer to try to answer as many questions as we can. But again, these videos are made with love and passion. I wanna grow the sport to levels that kickboxing has never seen. So it starts with subscribing and liking and sharing these videos.